Hello students, in this video we are going to study about the anatomy of earthworm. Before starting with the anatomy of earthworm, let us study about what the word anatomy means. Anatomy means to study about the internal features or the internal characteristics of the organisms. The features that present inside the body are the organs. So, in the anatomy we are going to study about various internal organs and their function. Let us start with the elementary canal of the earthworm. The body of the earthworm is covered externally by a thin cuticle or thin non-cellular cuticle called the epidermis. This epidermis is made up of two muscular layers, the outer circular or the and the longitudinal layer, and innermost layer is called the coelomic epithelium. This epithelium layer consists of columnar epithelial cells that has the function of secretion, and because it is having the function of secretion, that means there are the presence of secretory cells called secretory gland cells. The elementary canal of earthworm is straight tube like structure that runs from the first segment till the last segment of the body. The terminal position forms the mouth, and it opens into the buccal cavity and thus comprises of first three segments. After that, the buccal cavity leads to muscular pharynx and comprises of narrow and leads to small narrow tube like structure called esophagus and comprises of fifth to seventh segment of the body of earthworm. With the continuation of esophagus, then it leads to muscular gizzard. The function of gizzard is to break down the soil particles and the decaying leaves that are present, that are eaten up by the earthworm, and they are having the solid or the strongest material will be eaten up or the grinded by earthworm in muscular gizzard. Gizzard is something like a grinder which breaks down the bigger particles into smaller ones. Gizzard comprises of 8 to 9 segments. With the continuation of gizzard, it then leads to stomach that extends from 9 to 14 segments. And food of the earthworm, as we know, it is leaves, organic matter. So it is mixed with soil, and there are the presence of calciferous glands that are present in the stomach that neutralizes the humic acid present in the humus of the soil, and then it takes up and being digested in this part of the body that is called the stomach. And stomach comprises of 9 to 14 segments of the body. With the stomach, there are, as we go after the stomach, there is intestine, and it consists or the comprises of segments from 15 till the last segment of the body. In intestine, there is a presence of short conical structures or the projections called intestinal cecae. These intestinal cecae projects from the intestine at the 26th segment of the body. The characteristic feature of this intestine and between 26 to 35 segment is to have a internal median fold called Tiflosol. This Tiflosol increases the effectiveness in absorption, that is, as the fold increases, the absorption of the food increases. And after that, the food or the digested food is, absorbed food is absorbed at the fold that are present at the Tiflosol. It is a flap-like structure, and after the absorption, the excreted out or the egested food particles comes out from the Tiflosol, and they are excreted out with the help of nephridiospores that are present on the lateral side of the body. That's all with the elementary canal. Let us revise the number of segments and the organs that are present in these segments. First to three segments comprises of buccal cavity. 5 to 7 segments comprises of esophagus, where the food moves on. 8 to 9 segment comprises of muscular gizzard, where the grinding of heart or the larger particles are done and they are converted into the simpler or the soluble substances. 9 to 14 segments comprises of stomach. From 15th segment till the last segment of the body consists of intestine. 26th segment consists of intestinal cecum or CK as a plural word of cecum. And 26th and to 35th segments, there is a presence of Tiflosol, where the absorption of the food is done. That's all with the anatomy of elementary canal. Thank you for watching this video.